Hi, Dan Market here. I've been asked to give all of you an update as to what we're going to be doing here at Spirit Lutheran as it relates to the construction project. We're going to walk through a couple of floor plans and I'll just kind of give you a highlight. But before we get into that, I do want you to know that the building committee and the design team have really kind of somewhat changed the scope of what we had introduced to you many months ago. Many months ago, we had a large gathering area and an elevator, restrooms, but what we weren't doing back then, we weren't going to do any renovation to the sanctuary. So I'm gonna go through what we are doing to give you just a little bit of an idea. So let's go to the first floor plan. So this is the main level of the church. And what we are going to be doing over here on the right-hand side, we're going to be adding a new vestibule area with an elevator to get easy access down to the current fellowship hall. We also are going to open up the existing stairwell so that it is way more inviting than it is today. Today it's very closed off. It'll be all wide open, so it'll be more inviting for people to want to wander down to the lower fellowship area. We also are going to be upgrading the current narthex and the link going over to the education building. We also are going to be adding restrooms along the side of the existing sanctuary, both men and women restrooms and a family restroom. In order to do that, the first thing we're going to do is remodel over here on the education wing for the new administrative office areas. They'll have their own entrance out here towards Main Street, which will actually lead to a small parking lot for the daily use of people stopping in and out to see the people in the office. We're also going to be air conditioning the main floor of the education wing and office area. We'll go down just briefly to the lower level. Down the lower level, we basically are taking the very inadequate restrooms that we have today and we're going to increase the size and have a men and women's restroom that are much more functional than they are today. The main purpose of the changes is we decided when COVID hit, number one, we should try to reduce the costs as much as we can, but that we should also utilize the square footage of the building that we currently have. So the decision was made to try to use the current fellowship hall moving forward, but make it easier to get to via the stairs and the elevator. Can we go back to the main floor? Sure. And the other major change, since we are not doing the addition of the gathering out in front, we decided we wanted to spend the money to do the renovation of the sanctuary. The more that we worked on the project, we kept coming back to ourselves and saying, we're remodeling all around the sanctuary, but we're not doing anything with the sanctuary, and that's where we spend the majority of our time. So the sanctuary will be getting renovated. It's going to be updated. I'm not confident showing you colors and things of what it's going to look like just yet because we're still working on that final design. But basically, we have, again, we've eliminated the gathering space out here towards Main Street so that we can afford to upgrade the sanctuary. I can tell you that the praise band will not be up in front all of the time. They'll be over here off to the side. The pews will be eliminated and we'll be bringing in pew chairs so that we can move these around for various functions of how we want to have them. And the altar area is going to be much more cleaner and just much more effective. So again, in a nutshell, we have really started out with the new vestibule, a larger area to come in, the elevator, the open stair, picking up new finishes over to the link, and putting in the offices in the current education area. All of that has basically reduced our budget roughly $800,000. And there there is gonna be a campaign kicking off shortly, or actually already is, for the congregation to try to raise another $400,000 to meet the budget needs. More on that later from somebody else. So that's all I got for you. Again, oh, and I do wanna just point out, the outside again with the covered canopy. This is kind of a nighttime view of the facility. It should be pretty exciting. Thanks for listening.